In this video, we will talk about what is anaphase lag, and we will compare and contrast the anaphase lag with non-disjunction of chromosomes that we have already discussed. So let's start the lecture. Hello, I'm Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com. Welcome to this visual lecture. So let's suppose this cell has to undergo the process of meiosis, and remember this anaphase lag can also occur during mitosis as well, and with a very similar mechanism. So let's suppose here these are the homologous chromosomes that are arranged on equator, and spindle fiber arise, and now what happens that during this is a metaphase, and during anaphase these spindle fibers, they will pull these chromosomes, right? And here all these kinetochore spindle fibers, they were working very nicely, but here this kinetochore spindle fiber, it has lagged behind, right? It was not working nicely, it was lazy enough that it could not pull this chromosome enough as these. So it has lagged behind, and it has lagged behind during anaphase, and this is called anaphase lag. And what is the result of this anaphase lag? So this cell has divided, and now nuclear membrane will appear, and now you can see what happened here, that this spindle fiber which had lagged behind, because of that this chromosome, it has also lagged behind, and it failed to come inside the nucleus. It remained inside the cytoplasm, right? So because of this, because it cannot go into its proper demarcated place, that is nucleus, it has been stuck into the cytoplasm, so it will be destroyed. Now what is the end result? That here is that disastrous situation, that in this cell one of that chromosome, that it has been lost. So if there is lost of one chromosome, we call this situation as monosomy. So because of anaphase lag, there is monosomy here. Now let's compare it with the non-disjunction. That here, let's suppose non-disjunction is going on, and here anaphase lag is going on. So here you can see during metaphase, during anaphase, that this spindle, it pulled both of these chromosomes with it. So these two homologous chromosomes, they failed to disjoint, they failed to separate. But here there is not non-disjunction. They separated successfully, but this spindle fiber, it lagged behind. And what will be the end result? End result will be that there will be monosomy here. In one of the cell there will be monosomy, one less chromosome, and in the other cell, that cell is pretty much normal. But due to non-disjunction, what happened here is that there is, in one of the cell there is extra chromosome, but in the other cell there is monosomy. So what happens in non-disjunction? Both of the cell will be abnormal. Both of the daughter cells will be abnormal. One of the daughter cell will have extra chromosome, while other daughter cell will have one less chromosome. There will be loss of a chromosome. But compare that with anaphase lag, that one cell will be pretty much normal, but other cell will have monosomy. Clear? So this is anaphase lag, and this was the difference between non-disjunction and anaphase lag. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel.